I ain't gonna cry too long. I'm back on my drip. Drip my drip, my drip. Right back on my drip. Yeah. I ain't gonna cry too long. I'm back on my drip. Drip my drip, my drip. Right back on my drip. Fuck that nigga. I'm back on my drip.
That's the one right there. Just give me all of those. Episode 2, baby.
I don't really got nothing to say. Let's just like, subscribe, hit that bell. Let me know.
For that shit, way out of pocket.
He's live.
My shop! They destroyed everything! Bouncing banana blast! What have they done to you?
Louie? Lou, where are you? Come on, pal, you better just be looming somewhere like you always do.
Louie gonna be straight.
Lou! Make a bad joke if you hear me!
If Louie dies, we riot.
How did the robot get across the river? In a rowboat.
Sorry, Louie.
You're alive! I thought I lost you!
Incorrect. I am not alive. Nor did you or I change location. We are both still at Franz Froget's, the establishment famous on Promethea for its low yowl score.
I'm gonna need a moment to myself. I suggest you use it to teach that killbot of yours some manners.
Oh.
Another word out of him, and he'll be in pieces.
You risked your life to save mine. This is all my fault. I'm so sorry, Fran.
Fantastic! Fudge slide! Whip your butter, ripple blast! Kimchi lemon cowabunga.
Friend, what?
I have been unable to solar charge while
what is Friend talking about?
My analysis of the current situation indicates that I have ample time to deep charge while you wallow in despair. Wallow in despair. Please alert me when your wallowing is complete. Oh, yeah. That's good source. Entering power sleep.
Great. Awesome. My workplace is destroyed, my boss is on the verge of going nuclear, and the latest planetary invader wants me dead. Louis's right. I deserve a good wallow. This is me wallowing.
Oh. Master. She gonna think he dead. Watch.
Octavio!
Anya? Day keeps getting weirder. What the hell are you doing here? I thought you hated it down here. So, what's been in the hood?
I was worried about you. It's not safe here.
Not safe? Here?
There's an invasion going, and you nearly got blown up and... Oh, you're making fun of me.
Oh.
Listen, I know things between us haven't been...
Friendly? Loving? Respectful? Existent?
Ideal. But can we please at least talk about this, not in the epicenter of an invasion?
Putting aside her ego and ambition to look out for her little brother. Classic, Anu. That totally tracks with you ditching me here, by the way. And you don't look so put together yourself. Outfit torn, blood splattered on your face.
Don't do my drip. Don't do it.
As your loving brother, I gotta say.
Don't do it.
You look like hell. You look like you rolled through a rat's nest.
I've had a day.
A fun day?
No, a not fun day. A running for my life day.
Ah, yeah, those days happen here. Look, I get it. You don't handle conflict very well, but this isn't our first invasion. Pro tips, duck and cover, run and scream, and the third thing that I forget. It'll all blow over in a snap.
This isn't your garden variety invasion. Susan Caldwell invaded the Atlas Station too. She was convinced Reese Strongfork had a vault key and they wanted it.
Holy crap, seriously?
Yes, they showed up minutes after I was fired for the jabbers and I think they took my boss hostage and I stole his car and I crashed on this horrible planet and they were psychos and I killed one of them with this and I tore my outfit and I had to walk so far in these shoes to find you.
Whoa, 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 you killed someone?
Yes, Octavio, and I feel super weird about it. Bad weird. I have a lot of emotional unpacking to do, but not here. Not on this planet. On another planet with less killing. I would prefer less killing.
Damn, Anu. You're an ice cold killer now!
Shut up!
Murder! It's nothing to be ashamed of. Your bro has killed tons of haters in his day. It's all part of playing the business game.
I'm not interested in whatever your business is, and I'm certainly not playing anyone's game.
When you think about it, killing is just being born in reverse.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
You could use a treat. Cuckoo coconut.
Oh, that's awesome.
The last flavor to survive the attack.
Anu, this is Fran. She's taken care of me ever since you, well, left. Fran, this is Anu. My sister who was smart enough to get a job off-planet.
It's nice to meet you. And thank you, my friend. Ice cream.
Frozen yogurt.
Oh.
Fuck.
What's wrong with frozen yogurt?
Nothing. Nothing. There is nothing wrong with frozen yogurt.
Got the name mixed up. Relax.
Charging complete. As is.
Hop off my shaboin.
Who's this?
Louis? He's an assassination bot. But like a cool assassination bot.
Incorrect.
Louis, meet Anu, my sister.
This woman bears no resemblance to you. You may have been duped.
Families come in all shapes around here. The shape of mine is that Anu's my big sister, and I'm her more popular adopted baby brother.
I see. You seem non-hostile. I will not scan you for contracts that would oblige me to kill you. Your survival probability is 98%.
Oh?
See? Cool assassination bot.
We, never had anything like that at Atlas, shockingly.
Atlas? Oh no, Octavio! Not another paper pusher serving one of those heartless corporations that only exist to destroy people's lives.
What? No. Oh well, sort of, yes, but not me, no.
Atlas, Malawan, TDR, doesn't matter. You corp goons take what you want, you move on. You're the big people, and we're just the tiny ones getting squished beneath your heel.
No, really, I don't squish people. I left Atlas. I swear, I never
Girl, you was fired.
Design weapons. You can't just judge a person by their resume, you know.
Unless you are hiring them.
Well, sure.
I don't know. You sure seem like a corporate tool.
Just fired for refusing to make anything that would kill anyone. And for freeing lab jabbers.
Well, maybe not.
Plus, she's my sister. We share that free spirit DNA. Or what if we share DNA?
We get it, y'all. You're adopted. Like.
I don't smell too much of that Atlas stink on you. All right. You're okay with me, for now.
Thank me. Thank.
Hi, Nanu. Took her the better part of a year to trust me.
You trust him? What drugs are you putting in your froggert? He practically invented the concept of sticky fingers. He steals constantly.
Come on, Anu. You know my stealing days are behind me. Friend sure does. Back me up, friend. Friend knows what's up. Right, friend? Friend?
Don't bother me. I'm saying goodbye to the last remnants of my life's work here.
Really? That's how it's gonna be?
What was that option, bro?
Look, have I stolen in the past? Yes. Do I steal currently? I guess we'll never know.
Yes, we'll never know.
Yes, we just confirmed that you clearly, definitely steal.
Right.
Point is that even if I hypothetically stole, it hasn't landed me in hot water yet.
I guess we'll never know.
Secure around the perimeter.
What was that? I definitely heard something. Like, a radio.
TDR comm. Octavio's pocket.
Friend!
A TDR comms device? How the heck did you get this?
Well, it's a complicated story.
Stole it.
Friend!
Octavio!
Resistance has been minimal. We'll be back at base for happy hour. Half off banana daiquiris. A man finds what they're looking for. Daiquiri device. Whatever that is. Yeah, that's a daiquiri device, am I right?
They're looking for...
I think there was a vault key being kept on the station at Atlas. That's what TDR wanted. I don't know what they mean by doomsday device.
Probably something bad.
Which means whatever's in that vault has got to be something big.
Which means we need to get as far away from them as possible.
Or maybe as close as possible.
Are you completely insane?
We have here what they call in the business world...
A comms device.
An edge. If we can find whatever's in that vault before TDR does, we can change our lives.
No, it's not worth it.
I need to fix this.
TDR has many guns, talking guns, guns with legs. We will be killed by all the guns.
Your sister is correct. You probably will be.
You went to Atlas to build something great. Obviously, that didn't work out or they wouldn't have fired you.
Actually, it was more of a conscious uncoupling.
That is.
Yeah, she cleaned her shirt.
Oh no.
You never built your dream project because you never had real power, a real opportunity. But now we've got ears on a freaking vault. Whatever's in there, I guarantee you. You'll get an opportunity to build something great. To do something you were always meant to do. That's not me.
It also is not me.
It's me.
People call you?
What does he mean?
Anu, how are you? It's, well, it's been a while since I, you know.
Fired me.
Yeah, that.
A few hours ago.
Yeah. Ages. So, you know, ever since the Tedior attack, things up here have been,
crappy.
Catastrophically crappy. They stole our vault key. We had a vault key, and they stole it. And I know it's not mentioned in any of our brochures, but Atlas's entire business strategy sort of relies on it not being stolen. Anu, I am asking you, nay, begging you, please stop them from getting that vault treasure.
Why would you think I'm anywhere near?
Because you stole my car, Anu. And it can't be a huge shock that I can track where it is. And that's fine, actually. Right now, that's totally fine, because whatever Tedior's planning is gonna be just...
Apocalyptic?
Oh, yeah, nice vocab game. You know, I was gonna say so bad, but that's way better. This kid gets it. Keep him. Okay, well, I gotta run, because,
Hi, boss!
Looks like they're gonna... Wait, Timmy!
Bye, boss!
Hmm?
What's a Timmy?
Tedior has disabled Atlas's comms.
Timmy equals Tedior comms. Got it.
You definitely have...
Right, like what?
You really don't give a ratchet's ass about Atlas or Tedior. You ready to go to God knows where for this vault?
I suppose. Wherever it is, it can't be worse than here. I'm in.
This is in! I knew you'd come around. Fran, putting this plan into action is on you, girl.
Plan?
Don't call me that.
Noted. So, you come into Vault Town?
My shop is gone. I lost my temper. But I just need to sit somewhere quiet and visualize the pulp I'll beat Susan Coldwell into if I had the chance. I've lost enough to know that most adventures don't have happy endings.
Do it for your froyo shop.
It is. Was my fro everything.
Well, this vault treasure is their fro everything. Take away their froyo shop, friend. Take away their froyo shop!
They have a froyo shop.
It was a metaphor, a rhetorical parallel between your situation and theirs.
I was being facetious. Oh, I know what a metaphor is. I have my master's in linguistics.
Oh, how's that going for you? Right.
Stepped right into that.
Almost as if degrees are useless.
You always know how to weasel someone with words.
Lovable weasel?
Eh. All right. I'm in.
Yes! Fran makes three. We'll be unstoppable when you use your crazy mode on your hover chair.
We don't use that mode.
I do not use that mode anymore.
And Al-Zero, you what happened, Fran? Regardless of whether it involves paid human assassinations.
That's nice.
Now that you're officially a team, in the past 15 seconds, I've designed, programmed, and activated a teamwork morale sensor. It gathers data based on your behavior toward each other, and scores your camaraderie from 1 out of 10 skateboards.
Okay.
All sorts of data. Your speech, actions, how you look at each other, personal hygiene.
Whoa, what an awesome way to create team unity. Great work, Louis.
Flattery will not improve your teamwork score.
All right, bro.
It only appears... What's the human phrase? Thirst.
What's so important about a teamwork score?
The odds of you failing are already remarkably high. The remaining small chance of success depends entirely on your ability to work together and find cohesion as a team. Based on your interactions so far, your current rating is 4 out of 10 skateboards. You're all rude dudes with foul moods.
Well, whatever our score is, we start by gathering more information. That'll give us all what we want. Anu, They surely have VIP access codes to get off the planet. Fran, you get the whereabouts of Susan.
Susan.
And I can learn more about this vault treasure and strike it rich. We'll just eavesdrop on this comms for intel. It shouldn't take long at all. That.
Who this is? Billie Eilish? Finally cleaned the shirt. Song blows. My girl.
Us where Tidior's heading.
Zipper ripper athleisure wear?
No, it's not what they're saying, it's how they're saying it.
The Lycra really supports my delicate step.
The reverberations bouncing their voices. The faded signal. They're in a tunnel, maybe somewhere underground.
The sewer! I've got just the guy to help us.
And I have an entry to the sewer in the basement.
Why do you...
If you happen to see any corpses along the way, don't worry about them. They're just, yeah, don't worry about them. Well, let's quit dilly-dallying and get our butts to the sewer. Louis, guard the shop.
It is useless rubble.
Right.
It is my useless rubble. Come on, this way.
You've got a secret sewer exit built into your shop?
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool. Yes. If you see any bodies down here, pretend you didn't.
Why would we... talk about something we definitely won't see. Got it. Paco! Good friend of mine.
Shut up, moron.
Oh.
Decent friend.
Do you wanna die?
Oh.
Acquaintance.
You're heading into a battalion of Tidior troops.
How do you know that?
I snuck a tracker into your clothes in case
Why
I ever needed to kill you. Stay quiet. Sneak. Don't run.
Good job. We're gonna end this first one right here real quick. Appreciate y'all for tuning in. If you couldn't tell, I've been playing with the volume this whole episode. I'm trying to figure out. Y'all don't care, whatever. Make sure you leave a like, subscribe. You know all of the you know all of that. Tell me what y'all think about the squad meeting up. You feel me? Like, y'all know what I'm saying. Just talk to me. Talk to me in the comments. I'll check y'all. I'll catch y'all later.
I can, but I guess I gotta try again. Hello, the universe and me. We can be friends, I can tell, but you can't.